And we are pleased to be joined by Titans wide receiver Nick Westbrook-Ikhina. Nick, good to talk to you. Did you think at the beginning of the season, being in the wideout room with both A.J. Brown and Julio Jones, that you at the end of the season would be the second leading pass catcher for the Tennessee Titans?
I'll be honest, I was not thinking that. But, you know, just was glad to have the opportunity to be out there and share the field with them. You know, blessed to be in this opportunity right now.
Well, it certainly seems like you've become a reliable target in the passing game this season, and that Todd Downing and Ryan Tannehill have a lot of trust in your ability to get open and make big plays. How much fun has this been for you this year?
Yeah, it's been great. Like you said, I can feel more and more trust being gained, you know, throughout that process. And, you know, it's always fun to be, you know, counted on by somebody, you know, especially on this team and, you know, how we're, you know, making a push for the Super Bowl. So super thankful that they are willing to be able to trust me, and just love every opportunity that I've been able to have.
Your breakout game was the second Colts game in Indy on Halloween. Only two catches, but one was for a touchdown to give your team the lead. And ever since that day, you seem to be rolling along.
Yeah, I mean, that was a great game for me. Obviously, I'm from Indiana, or not from Indiana, but went to school in Indiana. Got, you know, a lot of family and friends that live in Indiana. So it was a pretty special moment to be able to have, you know, another touchdown. My second one in my career against them. And it kind of just solidified that I felt like I should belong in this league. And I feel like it kind of helped me just realize that, you know, I'm supposed to be here and try to make the most of my opportunities.
You took a long, hard road, Nick, to get to the NFL and stick. Any doubts for you along the way?
Yeah, I mean, coming off this offseason, definitely, you know, after I got hurt and had ankle surgery, it was kind of a battle to get back to camp. And, you know, was struggling with that, you know, dealing with that injury, but fought through it, luckily, and came out on the other side and feel like I'm better for it.
Nick, why do you think your skills as a receiver are such a good match for this Todd Downing offense?
It's a not easy concept to be a part of, but they do a great job coaching it. So I kind of know exactly what's expected. So I feel like that's the biggest thing, is I know it's expected. So I know where I'm supposed to be, the type of plays that need to be made. And obviously in any passing attack, it comes down to just players making plays, and Ryan throws, you know, great balls, throws dimes out there, and makes it a lot easier for us as receivers to make those plays.
Of course, there were times this season when A.J. Brown and Julio Jones missed games either due to injury or illness, yet this offense and this team still did enough to win 12 games and get the one seed in the AFC playoffs. What does that say about this team's next man up mentality?
Yeah, that's one of the most impressive things that I've kind of noticed as this whole season has progressed and as we're moving forward, is just the next man up mentality that we kind of always talk about and people have bought into, that doesn't matter, you know, where you came from. It just matters what you do on game day and how you prepare for that game. And I feel like it showed up time and time again this season. It's led to us being the one seed and having this opportunity ahead of us.
If I'm doing my math correctly, I believe you were, what, 3 years old when Kevin Dyson got stopped at the one-yard line at Super Bowl 34. You've been around here long enough, though. You know these Titans fans have been waiting a long time for this. You're still a ways away from your first playoff game, but what do you expect the atmosphere to be like for the playoffs, your first game at Nissan Stadium next weekend?
Yeah, I mean, I already know it's going to be electric. They've shown us, you know, week in, week out, you know, our home game so far, especially those night games, what it can be like here and what the atmosphere can be like in Nissan Stadium. And I just can't wait for it. You know, not going to get too excited now, but, you know, I know what to expect, and I can't wait to see what they're going to bring.
You know, a lot's been said and written about your quarterback, Ryan Tannehill, and whether or not he has the stuff to lead the Tennessee Titans to a Super Bowl victory. How much confidence do you have in number 17?
I have all the confidence in the world. You know, he's helped me a lot grow as a receiver and then also just as a player, you know, in the league, just seeing how he approaches preparation for games and how he leads this team. So, yeah, I can't wait to see what he's going to do and how he's going to step up.
And, of course, Nick, there's been widespread speculation that you guys could get Derrick Henry back. How much better could this offense be if you get the King back in the lineup?
Yeah, I can't wait to see, you know, what he can bring to the table. Just even having him back in practice and just around the facility again, it just creates a buzz for us. You know, gets us excited to play, because you love watching him play and be out there and make plays, and just makes him play that much harder.
Hey, Nick, thanks again for joining us. Good luck in the playoffs.
Thank you. Appreciate it.